Okay, I'm going to go through the posture that we use for playing the bassoon whilst we're sitting down with Dawn here. So I'm going to go through this step by step. So Dawn, what I'd like you to do first is just move forward on your chair onto the front so that your bottom and your back aren't near the back of the chair, and so that your back's nice and straight upright. Okay, and I noticed that you had your feet tucked behind the legs of the chair first, and still now they're too far back, and you need to have the soles of your feet on the floor. And I'd actually put your left foot a little bit further in front than your right foot, and that's just a really, really stable position to play in. Okay, super. Right, I'd like you to lift up your bassoon. You might notice here that the bassoon is actually laying more towards the floor than flat, and if Dawn had been playing and there was any moisture in the butt joint of the bassoon, that would have all run down and soaked into all the pads in the higher parts of the bassoon, and then those pads will go mouldy and brittle and they won't seal, and we don't want that. So Dawn's just lifted the bassoon up onto her neck strap and she's holding it more in an upright position. Dawn, is your reed in the right position for you to play at the moment?
No. What we need to do is we need to make sure that the reed tip is horizontal, so that our head is straight and we're looking straight ahead. So if my reed tip is at an angle, my head would be like that, or it would be like that. But we need it nice and straight so that my head is nice and straight.
Okay, and then just the last thing is to make sure that you can read your music. You would always put the music in the music stand to the right hand side of the bassoon bell, so that the bassoon is slightly tilted across your body towards the left, and you can still see the music directly in front of you on the right hand side.